Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Recombu, and in front of me I'm holding the newly unveiled Honor 7C. So this is the company's new mid-range handset. It's taking over from the likes of last year's Honor 6X. Has a lot of the same functionality, but also a whole host of new premium features that we're kind of surprised to see at this price point in a package like this. So let's get into it. So first and foremost, what we have on the front here is a 5.99 inch 18:9 aspect ratio, so full view display as Honor and Huawei like to call it. It's a 720x1440 resolution, so HD but not full HD. But it's a pretty solid screen. If you've seen our Honor 7A hands-on, the viewing angles in this one seem a little bit better. Still got nice slim bezels there as well, so it's a really good full view experience. And of course, you have the option to expand apps that aren't designed for that aspect ratio to format and scale on it. Also up the top here, we have an 8-megapixel front-facing camera along with a special soft light, they're calling it, the smart selfie soft light. Lots of alliteration there, makes it sound good, but it actually gives you the option of, I'll fire it off just quickly so you can see it light up. Do this soft flash there. So you can see it's up here. What it actually allows you to do is it gives you two levels in auto mode of brightness and three levels in manual control. So you can actually kind of customize how well exposed your face is in low light scenarios. This is all based on research that Honor and Huawei have done that suggests that most of the selfies we take are in the evenings because you take it when you're out with your friends, at dinner, in a club, whatever. So it makes a lot of sense to have a decent low light experience there in the selfie game. And of course, there's a beauty mode in there too. The software experience that we're looking at here is Emotional UI 8.0. So not the latest build that we've seen from the likes of the Huawei P20 and P20 Pro, but it's still nonetheless a very up-to-date build. There's a few preloaded apps on there, things like themes as well, so lots of customization, and things like games which you can download. You don't have to commit to these aren't preloaded on the device, they're just suggested apps that Honor's kind of partnered with developers like Gameloft to kind of include out the box in this experience. Also, it's running on Android 8.0 Oreo as well, so not 8.1, but again, a pretty up-to-date build of the user experience here. And it is enabled by default. Emotional UI also has a few kind of unique features like one-handed mode built in there out the box, which on this almost 6-inch display is a really handy inclusion to have as well. So let's move around to the side of the phone. So we can see here we've got metal back, but we've actually got what feels like a plastic frame and plastic for the antenna as well. The SIM slot on the side here is actually a 3-in-1 SIM slot, so you can support two SIM cards simultaneously and a micro SD card up to 256 GB, which is a really nice inclusion. If you want that functionality, you have the option of dual SIM in there. Whilst on the back, we have a fingerprint sensor and a dual camera array with a dual tone LED flash. It's really nice to have. So like I said, metal back, even though there's some plastic around the edges. The fingerprint sensor supports gestures too. And then the camera up here, we have a 13 and a 2-megapixel dual setup. So what that actually allows you to do is, as with more premium handsets, the 2 meg is really just for additional data like depth. So you can do a bokeh mode, you can shoot with wide aperture, and you can actually adjust the aperture after the fact, which I'll show you quickly now. We'll jump back into the camera experience. Flip around to the front camera. So you can actually see, if I grab the slider here, the aperture level, you can slide it, and you might be able to see the left here, because the camera is detecting that this is nearer, it's actually putting that that area of the shot blurred. And it's a nice kind of feature to have. It feels like quite a premium inclusion here. Also, you might not have noticed there, but when I unlocked the phone, I didn't touch anything, but it does have a pin lock. What it is actually face unlock. So this is another premium feature that Honor is bringing down to this more affordable price point. So this phone actually, in Honor's own internal testing, it unlocked in around 0.58 seconds in optimum conditions. It actually undercut the likes of the iPhone X for face unlock, which is pretty impressive stuff. Obviously, the technology at play is slightly different, but nonetheless, it's really cool to have such a premium feature on this mid-range device. As well as the camera, we've talked about all that. Let's go inside the phone. So what we're rocking here is a Snapdragon 430 octa-core chipset, 1.8 gigahertz, backed up by 3 GB of RAM, and then there's 32 GB of onboard storage to supplement that micro SD expandability that I mentioned earlier, as well as a 3000 mAh battery. And if I flip it down here, you can see we have a micro USB port and a 3.5mm headphone jack. So you do still get a headphone jack if you're looking for a phone like that that won't break the bank. The main focus with the Honor 7C is that Honor's trying to undercut the likes of Samsung and even Vodafone with providing the first phone with a dual camera at this £170 price point, because this phone, when it launches at the end of April 2018, is going to cost £16,999. So that's about everything I can tell you about the Honor 7C right now. If you want to know more, stay tuned to the Recombu YouTube channel. Don't forget to hit subscribe and consider clicking the bell, and then you'll be the first to know when we post a full review of this phone and much more stuff to follow. Thanks for watching.